girl from gym class?
No, that's me.
Oh. Who is she and why does she have her own song?
Did someone take my lunch?
Pepper Ann, Pepper Ann, marching in her own parade. Pepper Ann, she's like one in a million. Pepper Ann, Pepper Ann, much too cool for seventh grade. No one's cooler than Pepper Ann. She's her own biggest fan, Pepper Ann.
Ooh, a glowing green stick.
Catch her if you can, Pepper Ann.
Come on, Steve. You barfed in my fuzzy slippers 3 times this week.
Our appointment's in 10 minutes, Peppy.
Steve, I know how much you hate the vet, but it'll be okay, I promise.
Oh! I think my new chameleon's really sick. He keeps changing color. First he's green, then look, he's turning brown.
Pepper Ann?
Yo, right here.
Pepper Ann, your cat Steve appears to have a digestive problem.
Oh, I'll say. You ever stick your foot into a slipper filled with cat vomit? So, what's he need? Some pills? Last time, we had to give him some of these big old nasty pills. We'd be like, come on, Steve, swallow it. And he'd be all like, rawr, no way. And then we'd be like,
I'm afraid it's a bit more complicated than that.
Why? What's wrong? Where's Steve?
I should warn you. We've diagnosed Steve with something potentially serious called acute feline pancreatitis.
Steve, no.
Well, there must be something we can do.
Well, we are giving him steady intravenous fluids, but all we can do is wait and see if the inflammation in his pancreas subsides.
But what if it doesn't?
We just have to wait. But if things don't improve, you might have a very difficult decision to make.
Peppy, sometimes, when an animal is suffering, the only way to relieve that suffering is to...
What? To pull the plug? Steve's a cat, Mom, not a toaster.
We have to hope that Steve gets better. But if he doesn't, then we have to... You know, it won't hurt. They'll just give Steve a shot and he'll drift off, sort of to sleep.
And then what?
Well, we'll come home and cry and miss Steve. And then, after a while, maybe we can get a new kitten. Maybe a nice, furry Persian that'll sit in your lap and chase its tail every...
No, not what happens to us. What happens to Steve? It doesn't say anything in here about what's going to happen to Steve after he's gone.
Well, I would imagine that Steve would go to, to some sort of pet afterlife. Where he'd have little kitty wings and a little kitty halo and maybe even a little kitty harp.
Come on, Mom. You expect me to believe that? He has claws. How's he supposed to play the harp with claws?
You know, I think you might be taking my explanation a little too literally.
But I need to know.
Peppy, the truth is, I don't know for sure where Steve's going to go or what's going to happen to him if he does die. None of us do.
I promise, Steve, it would be okay. If I have to pull the plug on him, I need to know he's going someplace nice.
So, you say you wanna learn about the flora and the fauna.
Excuse me, Mr. Finky? I don't mean to change the subject. You know, learning about the origins of life is fascinating and everything, but what about the end of life? Do we ever get a death education class? I mean, we're all gonna die someday, right? That's just how it goes. Sure, we all have these big dreams of going on to high school and wearing eyeshadow, but no matter what choo-choo train you buy a ticket for, we're all getting off at the same stop. The big D, death. Let's face it, people, we're driving blind into the great beyond. Am I the only one who cares?
I'm sorry, what was your question?
These books are great at asking questions about the meaning of death, but I'm past that. I need answers.
Every mainstream religion provides a different theory on the afterlife, from the Christian heaven to the karma-driven reincarnation of Buddhism. There's not, however, any references to cats.
Look no further, PA. Steve can achieve life after death through his art. Like the work of Cezanne, Rembrandt, Picasso, Steve's clawed curtains and muddy paw prints will live on. Even the artist that sculpted the otter statue has achieved the ultimate, immortality.
Thanks, guys, but I think it's time to consult some experts. Hey, guys. I need to know about death.
Do you mean Death McGinty? He's still in home ec. Or Death Brumley? She's out today with the sniffles.
Death Wilson? Greetings, mortal. I am Lady Astor, mistress of the tomb.
Pepper Ann, pleased to meet you.
So, you have come to the macabre world of the Muerte lunch table, seeking knowledge of Mother Death and her many secrets.
Yeah, that's it exactly. So, what happens after we die?
Well, did I mention that Mother Death has many, many secrets? Maybe, Baron von Guss, our minister of disenchantment, can help you out with the specifics.
To be Muerte is to be one with the macabre mystery that is divine death.
But that's not telling me anything. Death isn't some frivolous fashion statement. Don't you have the slightest idea what it really means?
Look, what are you talking about? This just gives us an excuse to look really cool and outrageous, okay?
Yeah, I mean, look at me. I'm not making the basketball team or getting cast as the lead in the school play anytime soon, understand? This is all I got.
So you don't really know any more about death than I do.
Sorry, but the way we figure it, better to be noticed for something ominous than not noticed at all. Are you gonna eat the rest of that cookie?
You've come at a good time. The portal to the spirit world is very strong today.
You can really speak to people from beyond?
Yes, the one you asked about, Steve. I can hear his voice all around us. Steve's spirit is here. He's saying how much he misses you.
But Steve's alive, and he's a cat.
Oh, of course, of course. This must be Steve McQueen. It happens all the time. Well, I hope this journey into the spirit world has been helpful. That'll be $20, no personal checks.
No change yet, but there's still hope for a recovery.
Don't worry, buddy. I'm gonna get you some answers. I swear it.
Have you tried talking to people in your family? That can be helpful sometimes.
When you get to be our age, you can't afford to be guessing about where you go after you kick the bucket. You have to know.
And you have to plan.
I'm so glad I came to you guys. You two seem to be the only ones who have any real grasp of...
And here we are.
Row 9, plots 11 and 12.
Should be very comfortable.
I know the guy who does the thing. Slipped him an extra fiver for a nice shady spot, huh?
No, but spiritually speaking, where will you go?
Lord, I'm not speaking English. Row 9, plots 11 and 12.
Very simple, Peppy. 11 is for me and 12 is for him.
11 for you? I'm sitting here and I'm remembering that I get 11.
No! Leo, 12 is for you.
I get 12? I'm stuck with 12? Suddenly I'm supposed to rest in peace with a tree root sticking into my back? You know how much I hate that.
Thanks, Grandma. Thanks, Grandpa. I think I'll just walk home.
Are you happy? Your kvetching has driven away our granddaughter.
But I always sleep on the left.
Why do I need to get up?
Never gonna figure out this death thing. I'm sorry, Steve. Craig?
Hey.
Hey.
My grandfather.
Yeah?
I come here and jam for him sometimes. He's the one that taught me to play.
Wow. I didn't know that.
When he died, I quit guitar. I thought, you know, he's dead and gone. And someday we're all just gonna be dead and gone. You know, what's the point?
I've been feeling that way a lot lately. So what happened?
One day, I got the courage to play a note. Just one. And when I heard it, it was like he was still alive.
Wow.
Yeah, I realized that all the things he taught me, all the time we spent together, it wasn't really gone. It's all right here, inside me.
Thanks, Craig. I gotta run.
Catch you later, Pearson.
Pepper Ann, I've been calling your house.
It's okay, Doc. I'm ready to face this now. So, it's time. You're gonna, you know, pull the plug?
Well, that's how we do it.
Could you give us a
just a moment alone first?
I gotta get this thing to the shop, see if there's anything I can salvage.
Have you no compassion, man? I'm just asking you for 1 minute here. Goodbye, Steve. You'll always be with me. I know that now.
Pepe, it's okay!
I know it is, Mom. The times that Steve and I shared are going to live on in my memory forever. Okay, do it. Just do it.
A lot of fuss over a soda machine.
Soda machine?
You've got nothing to worry about, little lady. I'm gonna take real good care of Steve here.
Where's my cat? Steve!
The inflammation subsided just a couple of hours ago. Steve's going to be just fine.
Oh, Steve! Mom, let's go home.
Oh, it's so great to have Steve back. But you'd think that for $600, the hospital could have at least cleaned his teeth.
Mom!
I'm just saying. I think I'll write a letter.
Moose! Come on! You've been in there forever! Get out, you big old bathroom hog! Get out! Get out! Get out! Oh, Moose, sweet little sister Moose. Why didn't you tell me you joined the Jaybirds? I hope you love Jaybirds as much as I did. Being a Jaybird has meant everything to me. Why, it helped shape the confident young woman I am today.
I'm not officially in yet.
Ah, yes. The nesting requirements. Memorizing the oath, signing the personal injury waiver, finding a Jaybird sponsor who graduated with a complete vest of merit ribbons.
Peppy, will you be my sponsor?
Me? Oh, Moose, I'd love to.
Cool. Well, I gotta go get my waiver notarized.
I'm sorry, but I'm afraid you're not eligible to sponsor Moose as a candidate for Jaybirds. You're one merit ribbon short, Pepper Ann.
That's impossible. I'm sure I earned all my merit ribbons.
Well, our records show that you never finished the Jaybird go-kart rally to earn your last ribbon.
What happened, Peppy?
Oh my gosh, she was just here and
where's
now
she's
gone.
Where's the chick? Where's the race?
But that was the only Daeth!
We apologize, Pepper Ann. But without that last ribbon, technically you shouldn't have been allowed to graduate.
Jaybirds was under lax management at the time, wasn't it, Ms. Nadine?
My, my. This must be the biggest graduating class in the history of the Jaybirds.
Well, Ms. Nadine keeps records of all the merit ribbons earned. I'm sure she would be here if someone didn't get them all.
Are you trying to tell me I'm not a Jaybird?
It's okay. I'm sure I can get Constance Goldman to sponsor me.
But all these years, I've been living a lie. All these years, I've been using my Jaybird 10% discount card at Tweets and Tassels.
We're going to need that card back.
I hate to do this, but it just wouldn't be right for you to wear the Jaybird pin. Now would it?
My nesting picture! Please, let me be a Jaybird again. Let me earn that last ribbon.
Sorry, it's been over 5 years. If you want to be a Jaybird, you're going to have to start from ground zero like the other fledglings.
Start over?
That's an awful lot of work, Pepper Ann. Are you sure you want to go through all that again? I mean, you're not 7 years old anymore.
You don't think I know that? Excuse me, could I get this in a bigger size?
Oh, that's the biggest size we've got, sweetie.
I want to do this, Nikki. Besides, it'll give me a chance to bond with my little sister.
Are you going to sell those delicious Jaybird clusters?
Got the order form right here. What do you want?
Coconut clusters! Coconut clusters! I want coconut clusters!
I can't believe they're still selling those artery-clogging, cavity-causing concoctions of refined sugars and saturated fats.
I'll take 5 boxes. No, wait. 500!
Milo, they're $3 a box.
One, then.
And now, as the sponsors place the inaugural beanies on their fledglings' heads, please join me in reciting the Jaybird Oath.
We the Jaybirds of Nest 33 promise to do our best to make friends, others have fun, play it safe, and promise never to become communists.
We gotta revise that thing.
Tweet, tweet! Congratulations! You are officially Jaybird fledglings.
I think I'll give Moose a little time to socialize, you know, without Big Sister looking over her shoulder.
Well, I guess that's long enough. So, you guys ready to earn some ribbons or what?
I'm Moose. What's your name?
I'm Elkie. Oops! Thanks.
Aw, fledglings making friends. Boy, does that take me back.
You guys still on the square nut?
You think I should try again?
Nah, that's close enough. Step it up, fledglings! 3 more miles and that hiking ribbon's ours!
Peppy, can we slow down?
Slow down? Moose, are you feeling overshadowed by your big sister again? The only reason I can do everything so much better than you is because I'm older and I've earned these ribbons before.
Yeah, you've earned them before. But for us, it's the first time. We're still learning everything. And like Ms. Bernadette said, we need time to feel the wind under our wings.
If you want to feel the wind, you've got to fly, baby, fly!
To beautify the community really gives you a great feeling, doesn't it?
Great, great, great. Yeah. Now, come on. We've got to hurry and get back in time for Ms. Bernadette to sign off on the merit ribbon.
Isn't that Vera? I bet she could use some help carrying those groceries.
Moose, Vera lives 4 blocks in the opposite direction of where Mrs. B is to sign off on the ribbon. If Mrs. B doesn't sign off on the ribbon, we can't get the ribbon.
We can get it tomorrow. Come on, everyone. Let's go help Vera.
Yay! Tweet, tweet! Help is what I do best. All right.
Hi, Vera.
Back, back. I told you, vultures, I don't want to read your literature.
Come on, Peppy. It'll be fun.
Fun? Fun is a vest full of merit ribbons. That's what fun is.
Ah! Wait, Dieter, come back. Honeydew on a stick!
I wish people would realize nature's sweets can taste just as decadent as those infernal clusters.
Clusters? You got my coconut clusters? Wait! These aren't coconut clusters!
Oh, yeah. They discontinued the coconut cluster, so they sent you the new reduced-fat vanilla roux.
What?
Sorry, Milo. I've got to get ready for the go-kart rally ribbon. It's the last one. The last one! I'm this close to being a Jaybird, and there's no way that ribbon is going to slip through my fingers twice.
Discontinued?
Hey, Nikki, do you remember where I put my old go-kart?
Pepper Ann, you built that thing 5 years ago, and even then it was a pile of junk.
Reduced fat?
It doesn't have to win any beauty contests, just as long as it gets me across the finish line.
Vanilla Roos!
The rally's tomorrow. Hope you both can make it.
And support the organization that crushed my spirit into weeping little cluster crumbs? You've got another thing coming, sister!
You've got another thing coming.
Reduced fat. The only thing reduced about this candy is the intelligence of the consumer.
Let's get this show on the road.
On your mark. Get set.
Bring back the coconut cluster. Bring back the cluster.
Out of my way. I'm getting my ribbon and no one's gonna stop me.
Happy.
Hold on. I know what you're gonna say. I shouldn't have been driving this pile of junk. It's not safe.
What is it with you lately? Everything's about making friends, helping others, having fun, or playing it safe. You act like that's the Jaybird oath or something.
Peppy, it is.
We, the Jaybirds of Nest 33, promise to do our best to make friends, help others, have fun, play it safe. So what's your point?
I was gonna say, you can still race. Your go-kart just needs wheels and mine are still good.
Come on! You can't get your ribbon unless you cross the finish line!
You guys would do that? For me?
Like the Feathership motto says, Jaybirds of a feather stick together forever. You'll be there for me.
And I'll be there for you.
You gave Moose your go-kart? But it's an annual rally. You won't get another chance to earn that ribbon for a whole year.
Like the Feathership motto says, Jaybirds of a feather stick together forever.
Yay, Moose!
Congratulations, Moose.
Thanks, Peppy. I know how much this ribbon meant to you.
Maybe it meant a little too much. Yes, I admit, I may have gotten a teensy bit obsessed over earning those Jaybird merit ribbons, but thanks to you, I realized it's not about ribbons or pins or a 10% discount card. Moose, you taught me the true meaning of being a Jaybird, and I wouldn't give that up for anything. Except maybe for that discount card. Or free French fries.
Who knew vanilla roux would be so tasty?
The reduced fat, you know.
You're not gonna tell anybody, are you?
You keep your trap shut and so will I.